Hi, this is Randy Rosetta with NOLA.com and the Times-Picayune with an LSU baseball vlog. After the number one ranked Tigers kind of plugged away to get past Missouri 8-3 in a game that was anything but ordinary, and it started 3 hours before the game when Paul Mainieri found out that senior Jared Foster had been ruled academically ineligible, or technically will be as of next week. Did not pass enough classes to stay eligible as a senior going into the postseason. So abruptly and sadly, Jared Foster's career at LSU is over. It's a loss for LSU because he had emerged as a reliable guy at second base and gave them a very potent number nine hitter in the lineup. But as I tweeted this earlier tonight, if there was one spot, one guy LSU could maybe absorb losing at this point of the season, that was maybe the spot and the guy. And Danny Zardone kind of made that prophetic as he was a key to this win tonight. LSU was struggling a little bit with Missouri pitcher Reggie McClain the first couple of innings. He didn't seem to be having much trouble with his changeup, getting Tigers out, LSU Tigers. And then all of a sudden, Danny Zardone took one over the fence in left field. Missouri was ahead 2-0 at the time. That cut the lead in half, and that seemed to both rattle McClain and get LSU going. McClain had walked only 14 guys all season, and then he walked the next two after giving up the home run, and that kind of set the table for what turned out to be a four-run inning. LSU took the lead 4-2, never looked back. Missouri got a run the next inning. LSU answered with a couple and then tacked on a couple of runs. Not the best of nights for Jared Poche, who had been really sharp the last five or six starts. He didn't make it through the fourth inning. A key, though, that was that two freshmen out of the bullpen really picked him up and gave LSU a lift. Doug Norman came in, got the last out of the fourth inning with Missouri threatening to tie or go ahead, and then pitched two more scoreless innings. Didn't give up a hit in 2.1 innings. And then Jake Godfrey came in and logged a couple of scoreless innings. They weren't perfect. He gave up a hit in each of them to kind of get himself in trouble, but he seems to be one of those guys that is almost better when there is some noise on the base paths around him. And then Alden Cartwright finished up. LSU had 11 hits. A key, though, is that they had six of those with runners in scoring position, went 6-for-11, and another mind-boggling number. LSU stole 8 bases tonight against Missouri. That's their most in a game since 1995. Anytime they got a guy on first base, it was almost a guarantee that he was going to go. Brett Bond had no answer. The Missouri's freshman catcher, who's basically in the lineup because he swings a good bat, but he really struggled. Not just throwing runners out, he let pitches get by him. Just wasn't real sharp. And as a result of that, Missouri wound up with 4 errors, which was their most in an SEC game this season. They've kind of prided themselves on pitching and defense, and both kind of let them down tonight. But LSU was a big reason why. They got the 11 hits, they took the lead when they needed to, and they got solid relief pitching. So they take the series opener. That's 7 times in 9 SEC weekends when they've gotten the opening game, and they go into Saturday night's game here at Alex Box Stadium with Alex Lang going against Tanner Houck, a matchup of two very good freshman pitchers. Should be fun to watch. Doesn't get started till 7:30 p.m. tomorrow night here at Alex Box Stadium. We'll be on the SEC Network, but follow along NOLA.com for in-game updates. This is Randy Rosetta with NOLA.com and the Times-Picayune.